slow. So we're going slow. Actually can't get into second.
Oh, we're up at the top. This is a bit different from the olden days.
Went up and camped in the saddle up there in 66 or also. Watch the sunset from the top as the clouds rolled in. The track goes up in that sunshine. The view from the top is well worth the climb, it says. 3 to 4 hours return, which is not bad. You can look out on the surrounding farming area. See some people up here somewhere in the saddle and get bits of track now and again. Not sure where it goes up now. Let's cross over. Didn't remember it sort of going straight up. Good seal road in. Massive structure. It'll withstand 1,000 years. We've got a rubberized walking track now. Goes up down there. Ends in the dirt. Tourists. Ask them where the track goes. A coach load of seniors have just arrived. And the sun's come out again. Nobody can positively identify the track up. We reckon it went straight up there years ago, but now it follows that little saddle there, and they reckon it goes across up into there. Sunset near Toolburn up. Got a nice bush camping spot in the national park. That guy's done 36,000 km over 8 months. Well, This is not far from Toolburn up. Yeah, camp spot spread across the log barrier. Back the trailer up to the edge. Kitchen out. And we had the Jones little insect tent last night, which was excellent. Yeah, all the flying ants came and invaded us. There's two of them up through the trees. The guy in the Land Rover has done several months. And there's Anthony and Barbie over there. And that's the rainwater tanks. We've got rusty water in the taps nearby. Well, we've headed off on the drive that wanders around through the middle of the park, gone past Mount Hassel and Toolburn up. And we're going to have to come back in a couple of years. The sun's gone out. This is a mountain pea of some description. Road through the middle of the park. This endangered Banksias and prickly thing. Oh, it's a hatia, I think. Look at
yeah, it.
Huge knobs. There's Mount Hassel up there. I think it's Mount Hassel because it's one of the steeper climbs. Wow, it's all along the edges of the road. You don't have to go very far. See the track. There's the road. And the track up. Up Mount Hassel. I think this is a new road. We'll have to look into when it was constructed. When Ian Williams and I walked up Goulburn up. There, don't remember a road through the middle. The north side is Toolburn up, the northwest side. Now we're on the western side of Toolburn up. We're going north. The sun's just come out, well for a moment, went back again. Toolburn up's got into the sun. This is Mount Hassel over here. A bit of shade on that one. Ogog and Magog. Gog and Magog. Going over a saddle. We can see back to Bluff Knoll. Looking spectacular in the east. Moving up. And that one up there is Tullyabola. And we're looking back over to Bluff Knoll.
It's just come out for a few seconds. Hakeas and there's a lot of flowering gums around on the side of the road. Like boys, and the cloud just blew over. The sun came out here. A little blaze of sunshine now. And clouds have blown over past us towards Silverton up over there. This is a very prickly one. I'm having trouble identifying some of them.
The hook's not big enough.
Yeah. He's spiky. Spiky fellow. The ranger said you can see most things just on the edge of the road. This one's on the edge of the road spoil. It's a dead looking stick.
Climbing up a narrow steep pass now. Relatively speaking, there's the grass trees, xanthereas and blackboy farm over there on the slope. And facing west, and that's looking north. And behind is a very dry slope. And the sun's out again. That's the valley we just came up. Sprouting like mad. It's gone again. Little casuarina. Flowering eucalypt in the rocks. Maybe where you look. Some intrepid farmer decided to fence it off. Didn't have enough land down there.
we just came up a steep bit of road at a lookout, and the wind was howling down the track, blowing dust down the track. It's very Montana-like. This plant's called Banksia montana. Montane this and montane that. Scenic lookout back towards Toolburn up and the other many peaks. There's a bit of a track going up through the thick scrub, most of it's impenetrable. The sun came out for a second. You just look around through the bush. There's flowering bits everywhere. You got it? Yellowy leaves and yellow flowers.
Not much,
though. Seeds. Seeds stuck to the petals. And there's the dieback from the Phytophthora. It's moving through the area downhill from the road often. Banksias and black boys all dead. This one has, he hasn't flowered yet, so another week or so. There's some big trees in the area. They used to take timber out. Sandalwood out, export it to China. Well, in the 50s, or before the 50s, they used to camp around here and drink red overproof rum. In the 50s, there were kangaroos and goannas and all manner of wildlife around the spring, but it's long dried up now. Hasn't flowed for a while. There's a lot of hidden bird life here. We're seeing a crow here.
Or something, I don't know. I'll look it up.
Mary's looking at in the bush. Between the clouds.
This is less foliage.
Nice soft foliage on that one. Common old pig face, right near our letter box.
Is it?
Well, we're
just left the Stirling Ranges National Park and the rain's come down. Just going west for a bit. Well, it was raining just back there. Now we've hit a dust storm.
It's also raining.
And it blows past there now.
Oh,
the rain went through the north.
Somebody's ploughed a paddock and lost its topsoil.
Farm forestry. Farm forestry project. Blowing away crops on the left side and the mallee plantation on the right.
Some nice croplands driving across country. I was talking to Julie McKinnon in Brisbane about the wedding and our alternator's overcharging again. We're just driving into the western setting sun and saw this lovely letterbox. And about 10k west of Frankland. It's a good flowing river. Further down, it's good for canoeing, kayaking, one of those great river trips. There's a lot of olive tree plantations, olive groves along the road. There's just a few of them here. From the river. We're heading off to Manjimup now, 4:15. And the sun's just come out again a moment ago. There's your olive plantations on the north side.
Gone again.
The sun's gone again. Past a few nature reserves and all along the edges are masses of bright coloured stuff and lots of sheep and cattle on different sides of the road, very green. Postman.
Maria.